Hi, everyone. Sandy Caligiuri, the Whiteface Mountain, as we have moved into the penultimate day of competition. Today is the final women's race of the World University Games. The slalom is ready to begin. Winter storm Izzy has brought some fringe effect snow to the Adirondacks. Overnight, Lake Placid received about 4 inches of fresh snow. We hope to have excellent race conditions well into the field of 74 athletes. As we take a look at the beginning of the start list, Valentina Macharay, she probably is going to enjoy racing with bib number one. She'll get the best conditions. Early will be good, no question about it, and then we'll just have to keep an eye on how things develop as we go through this extensive field in the first heat. We have 70 gates in all, and we're coming out of Thruway and onto Draper's Drop. Okay, Valentina Macharay, a 24-year-old skier from Fribourg in Switzerland. On course. Encounters a flush right off the bat. They had a 45-minute inspection period before the race. No training of any official kind in slalom, only in downhill. And we are not competing that at the World University Games. You get to free ski the hill earlier in the program, depending on when the teams arrive, but nothing official. And then you get to inspect it on the morning of the race, and then there'll be another inspection as they reset the course for run number two. Here's a lower flush into a hairpin. And this will be the early standard set by Valentina Macharay, 57.67 seconds. And we'll just have to take a look here and see how that stacks up. The second skier on course comes from Austria, 21-year-old Julia Gross. She's an all-event skier who won 3 FIS races last season. And you can hear it. You can hear that firm surface. So the field of skiers and the officials and the course workers, they all collaborated to slip the loose snow out. And there certainly is a remaining firm surface underneath, no doubt. Julia Gross in her first run, coming down Draper's Drop.
Now comes that tricky double flush.
In the flush, the hairpin that ensues. And now to the finish in 58.22, half a second, from Valentina Macharay. Slalom here is, it's the winter sport version of the 200-meter sprint. You punch the gates down, you shin them out of the way. Sometimes you use your forehead if you have to. And that's why they've got some protective face wear, almost like a quarterback's helmet. Carlota Marcora. Top of Draper's Drop.
Marcora.
The back and forth set there. Closing flush, and then 4/10 ahead. Marcora is in the lead by 4/10 of a second.
44/100 ahead of Nora Brand. It's Italian Carlota.
From Switzerland, Elian Christen. Yeah. 23-year-old skier from Andermatt. She was second in a fist slalom on January 4th in her home country. Skiing the flatter section up there, pretty good, 13 hundredths ahead. It hopes to bring that speed down onto the transition of Draper's drop and now the pitch. A bit wide there. We'll see if these tactics work out in her favor. Good skiing here by Kristen, but she did lose time. She lost close to a second. And may have just skied just a bit too round in some of those turns. From Sweden, Hedda Marteller. The Swedes won the team event yesterday. And they were regaling in that achievement. Marteller, her intermediate time. Well, she won't get one because she unfortunately has skied out of the course. It's unfortunate. It bounced around there a little bit and then straddled.
Come on, kid, up, up.
Our next skier is Katie Parker from Australia. A graduate student at the University of Utah from Melbourne, Australia. And she has gone out in the early stages. Sarah Rask from Sweden. Carlotta Marcora of Italy is our early leader by 4/10 of a second. Rask is a freshman from Denver University. Before she attended DU or opted to attend DU, she raced in 23 World Cup events. So this is a seasoned performer here. Again, somewhat wide and distant from the gates. Just trying to get through legally. Okay, about half a second out. That was pretty good. That puts her in third place. Another Australian, this is Madison Hoffman, a junior at the U of Utah. She was named to the Beijing Olympic team, but did not get to compete due to an ACL injury. Madison Hoffman. Quick feet through that slush, flush. And final time is 57.92, just over a second behind. Sometimes you just are reacting. You get a little bit behind, and then the ensuing gates are more of a reaction, and you rely on your athleticism to get you through. Denise Dingslader of Austria, 24 years of age, will turn 25 at the end of the month. A junior at Westminster College, Salt Lake City. Forest course set on the throughway part of this course. but the flushes that are coming up will break up the rhythm for sure, right there being one of them. And now another one, but the gates are tight in a vertical pattern. She's tied in 58-11, 1.3 behind. Well, we moved through that pretty quickly, I must say. Markora from Italy, Brand from Germany, Rask from Sweden, the top three. Kristen and Macheret, the Swiss, are 4-5. We have a tie for sixth. The top nine skiers in the first run standings came from the first seed of 15. Now those nine will ski at the other end of the top 30, and we'll see how that works out in the continuing snow and how the conditions will work for or against them. We did have Taya Lambore from France starting 29th in that first run, and she finished in 10th place. Taya Lambore, she had an excellent first run, finishing in 10th place, starting from, well, you see it. Her bib number there is 29. Some people are just not going to be denied. They're just not going to pay much attention to the start number, and she's ahead by about a second and a half.
Can you keep it completely, like, at one spot, and I can just move it with the arm?
Taya Lambore, okay, she's still good. She's still good. Yeah, that was a mistake there. Seemed to get pushed back a little bit on her skis. Here she comes. Will it cost her that much? No, actually. Great skiing. Half a second to the good. Taya Lambore of France. So right now, the skier who began the day with bib 29 sits in the lead. Julia Gross of Austria. A winner of three FIS races last season. Over the last couple of years, skiers are getting back into their routine of racing and traveling after being basically slammed shut with the coronavirus. The last handful of gates. Julia Gross, and she is ahead by almost half a second. And now things are really perking up. Denise Dingslater, a tenth of a second up as she pushes out. Things later, intermediate time. Boy, she is fast. Almost half a second up.
All right, we're back.
Things later. We'll turn 25 at the end of the month. Six-tenths of a second. Denise Dingslater. Austria 1-2. Dingslater leading by 6-tenths of a second over her teammate, Julia Gross. Madison Hoffman. Hoffman is from Sydney, Australia, a junior at the University of Utah. 22 years old. Fog just keeps pushing its way closer to the finish. Hoffman, 16 hundredths ahead. Madison Hoffman bumps Dingslater from first to second. So Madison Hoffman is leading with a time of 1:57.03. Julia Fletcher, six skiers left in this group of 30. And these are the six fastest in reverse order from the first run. 6 tenths behind right now. Fletcher is only 20 years old. She's racing mostly on the FIS series with some Europa Cup sprinkled in. Julia Fletcher is just a quarter of a second behind in third place. Valentina Macharay. In fact, she's calculating her way down that upper part of the course. Her split time puts her 3/4 of a second up. Whatever her strategy was right now, it's on point. A 24-year-old from Fribourg in Switzerland. Valentina Macharay, and she's through us ahead by 1.6 seconds. That is a whopping advantage. Eliane Christen from Andermatt in Switzerland. Another skier looks to just be calculating her way down that upper part of the course. 3/4 of a second behind. Kristen from Andermatt in Switzerland, pushing into the finish. And she's a second behind. And she is in second place. So we do have some gaps here where some skiers can't fit in. Sarah Rask as we move to the top three from the first run. Denver University freshman from Stockholm. A well-seasoned athlete at 22 years of age. She has raced in 23 World Cup events from 2018 to 2022. And then she decided to enroll at Denver University. She's won twice on the Europa Cup tour. Sarah Rask across the line, trailing by just 12 hundredths of a second. Sarah Rask of Sweden, second place. German Nora Brand. She's a junior from Munich, majoring in international studies, and 1600s ahead. Now she would like to take that all the way to the bottom.
Yeah, I'm gonna
try it again. Pull back up.
Nora Brand. She's had 3 wins and 2 seconds in FIS and NORAM events prior to the World University Games. Oh, got rocketed a little bit there, but she made it, no problem. And how does she do? A second out. Brand is in fourth place. And now, the final skier from the Flip 30, the leader of the first run, Carlotta Marcora from Italy. She had a substantial lead. And we'll see how she plays it. Right now, Masha Ray leads by 12 hundredths. Carlotta Maria Clara Marcora. She's trying to do what she can, racing 30th here. Conditions may not be ideal, but she's bringing it down in pretty good shape here. Let's see what it looks like. And she wins by a whopping 1.14 seconds. The gold medal for Carlotta Marcora. Marcora wins the title here at the World University Games. 'Forza Italia! Not easy skiing. Visibility not great, as we have seen throughout the day.
Puts together a great second run and takes home the silver. Sarah Rath, amazing 2 days, concludes with.
Marcora the gold, Masha Ray silver, Rask the bronze. And then a gap of about 0.9 seconds to fourth place for Elian Kristen. Well, as we look at the final runs, the replays here, Calvin Jory, once again, bidding you a good day.